If you ever paid attention to project management and development methodologies, you've likely heard the term waterfall. The waterfall method describes the development cycle where one proceeds through each phase in sequence, only advancing to the next phase when all requirements of the preceding phase have been completed. The first step in the waterfall model is to outline all requirements and/or specifications in the product requirements document. Once all requirements have been established, one proceeds to product design or architecture. Construction or implementation follows design, which results in the first workable product. Once all segments of the product have been successfully integrated and implemented, one proceeds to the verification, testing, or debugging phase. After all bugs have been squashed and the product is ready for delivery, the product is installed and/or brought to market. The final phase, maintenance, doesn't end until the product is discontinued or replaced. Why should you use the waterfall method? Various organizations have used the waterfall method, most of them in construction, manufacturing, and software. The United States Department of Defense adopted the waterfall method in June of 1985 for developing software of defense systems. But since then, most organizations have moved away from the methodology for various reasons. For new products or processes, the risk of early stage mistakes is often considered too great. If a mistake is made early in the requirement or design phase, it often isn't discovered until the verification or testing phase. If the mistake is significant enough, it can cause the entire product or process to fail. Ultimately, it is up to the individual project or product manager and their teams to determine which methodology is the best for their needs. To find out more about waterfall-based project management systems, check out our website where we can help you find software that fits the needs of your work. Thanks for watching.